Hello and welcome to another episode of BeamNG Rally. Before we can get started, I need to announce two things. First of all, there will be, from here on out, always two cars per episode. And the second announcement, the episodes will be releasing Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays. So, with that out of the way, let's get rolling. So, the first car today will be the GL83 Off-Road Turbo. Now, I remember that I had a third announcement, which is the link to every car will be in the description. So, let's get off the line. Now, GL83 got very good off the line. Now, when I searched for this mod, I thought, when I saw GL83, thought of a Mercedes, because GL, but yeah, it's an off-roader, so at least I've got an off-roader here. So going up the hill, it's really not going up fast, but you really hear, I think I overused really. The springs and everything bouncing in this car. And that will be the main problem with this car, that it is bouncy as fuck. And here it isn't even getting up the hill. Like, you got the hill before up and here you're getting problems. You're serious? So, going into the little bit faster part here, bouncing. You see really, like, yes, the suspension can take lots of stuff. It could jump very high heights, but it isn't really made for fast jumps. Which this track has caused some cars problems. Yeah, and here going through this section, it got very far in the first run, really. Going down here even. But here we have the same problem, like the back wants to overtake, and here we just get an unfortunate landing and it just flips the car over. Now, the next run, we bounce our way down. Can't get it stopped because if you have tires in the air, yeah, braking isn't really that good. Or better said, you can't brake with if you have wheels in the air, except you're an airplane. And they can't slow down much either. And at least we got a car flag with a small tree, yeah. And it was really interesting, this thing falling down just BOOM! Even though it didn't get much flat. Now here we're running a little bit wide and bumping into this pillar again. Here again, little bouncing on landing and hitting the second pillar. Now the thing was still working kind of, but it was, the suspension was a little bit damaged and it was running to the left and then hit this pillar here. Not ideal, I would say. Now here, bridge again. Not damaged tire, but I got so far to the left that I ripped my wheel off. Yes, I drove so far to the left I ripped my wheel off. It's really hard to see, but would urge you to watch it again. Here, running wide out of the first corner, going down the ravine here, but yes, that was a mistake before there where I just drove way too far left. I mean, it's all mistakes, but it was like so obvious mistake. Again, I'm running a little bit wide. It's like the most natural cause of crashing these cars is running wide or running too far on the inside in the first corner. Here again, as this is an off-road car, it will take lots of damage, so it doesn't get destroyed immediately. Here, that's like me braking too late out of the for the third corner down from the bridge and then just running wide. Here, really unsettled landing from the first jump down there, hitting the pyramid, destroying the radiator and then rolling down. Going for the full roll and getting stopped then from a tree. Yes, the tree saved us. Now here, our murdering corner, how will it murder this car? Well, it didn't murder the car, but I gave up this run because, fuck, I ran way too much. Here again, going in a full drift out of the first corner isn't the ideal thing, because you're going sideways down, but I catched it before I ran into the bridge again. Now, down the canyon, Again, car gets unsettled, Spec wants to overtake, and we flip it over a rock, or, I mean, everything is a rock, by definition, but we flip it over the hill, then roll it again onto the wheels, before getting it stopped. Yes, we are again on the bridge, with a tire punctuation, and nearly collecting the pillars. Yes, I'm... to, you know, okay, first corner is like the killer corner for this car. It's just again running wide out of the first corner, going down this ravine, but it doesn't get flagged on the bridge. I'm really disappointed by this. Here, running wide to the second corner, and then just, well, that's like, I think you could try to get on here. And another case of the pyramid killing a car, in this case, throwing it down on the sides where this off-roader has gone many, many times now. Another time, Canyon getting unsettled before the corner, then completely unsettled, and then starting to be rolling down the hill, and it will continue for some time before it loses a wheel and then decides to, well, stop it. But the wheel continues to roll down and is about to finish the race. Not really, because it should take a turn left before it could actually finish the race. It took more turn right. Here, getting a little bit unsettled again. Back overtaking, and we are rolling backwards. And that continues. I mean, sure enough, it's interesting to see this thing. Again, like before, down here a few crashes ago, where it rolled over, and here we just roll it over again. Now, again, going for some more rolls, and then you really saw the suspension just, when it came back to the wheels, it just jumped again up. It's like, it's of course made for heavy off-roading, not for rallying, and here the back just being catched off and then it rolls over, but the car doesn't have really much purpose. Now, here you see the final successful run. This why the perspective was so strange, is the car for some reason always respawned the air a little bit. But it's not like a problem for this thing. It's like, could throw it a few meters down, it's like, I don't give a shit. Yeah, it's completely constructed for off-roading, and this is a rally circuit, so it doesn't really deal good with this. And you see it's like slowly crawling up the hill. It is heavy, but I didn't have had much problems like the Roma where I rolled it over because of its high center of mass. It didn't have that problems, but it had problems with mass. That was clearly acceleration up hills, and I mean, it looked kind of decent, but also kind of looks not so good as a car to access its visuals. Now, I took this turn very slow. I think I could take it a little bit faster, but hey, I'm taking it a little bit slower, more cautious side. But I'm trying to push it as much as I can, trust this car not to basically immediately betray me and throw itself into the rock face. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of the problem with this. Here, nearly losing it to the side, which cost much time to slow it down there. But still keeping it under control and then going for the long part. Not shifting up really far into the red. But being slowed down here, not getting too bouncy. Car was really controlled in this run. Now here it gets again a little bit unsettled. I hit the brakes, slow down, make it cautious, and getting around the final corner. A little bit of going into the inside and then going over the line. The GL83 has done it. I mean, in general, this name doesn't roll very good from the tongue. GL83. Yeah, not the best name to roll from the tongue. So, we try to do this little bit of celebrate donuts, but not really successful, and run it down here before crashing it on a tree. Yeah, like always. So next up will be what you very likely clicked on for the thumbnail, is the pigeon dragster. Now I did a little mistake with building this car. I thought that the two barreling, whatever it is called, I should have researched it. I'm a little bit into cars, I will admit, but I'm not a complete expert on disassembling it. So yeah, I don't know what part is the intake, but this two barrel, I thought it was the best one before I discovered that it is the slowest one. Yeah, so we're driving with the slowest engine, with the least horsepower. But I think with the stage 4 supercharger, this would have been completely, utterly impossible. Now, again, it's another modded car. But it still had like lots of power because it's not much mass. Even though we have an entire different chassis for the pigeon. Yes, that thing is a pigeon. This, what is it, Italian-esque three-wheeler with a little bit more horsepower now. Yes, you realize it still tries to roll over and it runs wide here, but it was surprisingly easy to drive. I've expected it to be way, way worse. I did a little bit of test driving to test if the mod was working, and yeah, I've got reassured here that, and I thought, yeah, that's pretty hard to drive, and then I drive this and it's like, what? That's really fucking easy to drive down here. It's really controlled. Yes, I put the race brakes on here, that wear option, and it has the heavy duty suspension, and yes, it's working pretty well. And because it has a longer frame and two larger back wheels, it was running so great that I finished on the first run. And you think that I didn't notice when I watched this commentator's footage? Yes, I knew, but I didn't want to spoiler you. So, trying to go for donuts with this thing. Yes, this thing has just performed a zero run. Zero crashes. And was successful on the first run. I was blown away myself. And we of course roll it, but that wasn't enough. We need to fully launch this thing. Into the scenery, acceleration to the front. Yes, that thing is somewhat bonkers. And here completely going for the burning pigeon. But the pigeon can also, when you take it to dragster form, it's like really bonkers fast because it's really loud. But anyway, two times the pigeon dragster takes 2 minutes, 11 seconds, and 900 milliseconds and zero crashes. AKA, it will be always first place in least crashes. Except I'm for some reason getting minus one, but then I failed math. Then the GL83 needing 2 minutes, 22 seconds, and 300 milliseconds to get down, but needs 21 tries. So the pigeon goes into 6th place, beating with this the Legrand, but failing to beat the Sunburst race by both directions a relatively big margin. But the GL83 gets beaten by the Legrand, aka it's now the last place with 8th. But I would say that's something up to change, because next episode we'll be seeing two electric cars drive this track. How will you fare? You will be seeing next episode. Do not miss the next episode, subscribe to my channel, follow me on minds.com or join my Telegram channel. Links down in the description. Up to the next episode.